Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Human Respiration. In that we are studying topic inspiration and expiration. Now when I say inspiration, it means taking in of O2, and when I say expiration, it means removal out of CO2. But is that so simple? No. Let's study a little bit more about it. Inspiration and expiration, or you simply break down to inhalation or exhalation. Now when I say inhalation, you all will say that it is nothing but inhaling the mixture of gases through nostrils and then passing it through pharynx, larynx, your trachea, which is your windpipe, and then finally it reaches to lungs, and then your alveoli will basically exchange it in the tissues. That is, oxygen goes to tissues and then other parts via blood, and your carbon dioxide is removed with the help of carbonic anhydrase enzyme. But it's not so simple. There is a part of the lungs that is crucially involved in this mechanism, and which is your diaphragm. Now diaphragm is an arc-shaped structure just beneath your lungs. During the process of inhalation, or we say inspiration, your diaphragm basically contracts. And when I say contracts, it means it becomes flat. Now once your diaphragm becomes contract or flat, it is pulled down. Once it is pulled down, your thoracic cavity, or the cavity in which lungs are situated, become lesser and lesser, and your lungs will expand. Because your thoracic cavity is reducing, your lungs are going to expand. And once that happens, air pressure inside decreases. And if air pressure inside decreases, your process of inhalation, or you can say intake of all the gases from outside, could be readily filled in your respiratory system. In simple language, if I can say, the diaphragm in the process of inspiration is just vacating the lung system so that other gases which you're inhaling could come on easily and occupy their spaces. The next part is expiration or exhalation. Now exhalation would be direct opposite of this. During this process, diaphragm would contract. Lung, it will be pulled upwards. Your thoracic cavity reduces. Your lungs will reduce or shrink back to normal size. And air pressure inside will increase. If the air pressure increases, then only CO2 molecules will be pulled out. Inspiration or expiration, or you simply say it, inhalation or exhalation. Now during the process of inspiration or inhalation, what happens is that your diaphragm, or your arc shaped part just beneath your lungs, muscle become contract. And when I say contract, it means flat in the terms of respiration, due to which it is pulled down. Now obviously, if diaphragm is pulled down, don't you all think so, a little bit space is created? And if a space is created, we could say that thoracic cavity expands. Now if thoracic cavity expands, obviously your lungs are going to expand, and if lungs are going to expand, there will be an increased space available or area available. And if there is an increased space or area available, then all the molecules of gases which were initially present in little or lower space will have a little bit more space just to be there, and due to which air pressure inside decreases. Basically, all the molecules will get their required space. Expiration. Now, if I talk about expiration, I could say that your diaphragm muscle or your arc-shaped part just below your diaphragm become relaxed. Now, relaxed, it means it becomes arc-shaped or back to normal its C-shaped position. Now, once it comes back to its C-shaped position from initially being flat, once it forms that C-shaped arc, it is pulled upwards, obviously. And once that happens, your thoracic cavity will reduce because this arc-shaped structure will take a little bit of space. Once that happens, your lung size goes back to normal size because initially lungs were taking a little bit of space, due to which air pressure inside will increase. Obviously, there will be less amount of space available for all the molecules and the molecules of gas, which will be including other molecules like oxygen, carbon dioxide, will start fighting with each other. And once that happens, the molecules of gases, for example, there will be a lot of carbon dioxide in it and other gases. Oxygen will already be given to the tissue because this is a process of expiration or exhalation. Now, due to which carbon dioxide or CO2 is removed from the system. So students, in the part of inhalation, diaphragm basically becomes flat and everything goes down accordingly. But in the part of exhalation or expiration, diaphragm comes back to its arc or C-shape and the process goes on to remove carbon dioxide. Students, in this part of the chapter, we came across inspiration or inhalation, or you simply said expiration or exhalation. I hope you are very clear about this concept. Thank you.